बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स इन प्रोग्रेसिव मॉडल स्कूल पिशावर रोड रावलपिंडी, क्लास 7, सब्जेक्ट साइंस। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन आंसर 5 to 9 ऑन पेज नंबर 10, यूनिट नंबर 1, न्यूट्रिशन इन प्लांट। यू कैन नीड एनी हेल्प, सी द नोट्स। क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, व्हाट इज यूनिक अबाउट लिचन। लिचन इज अ गुड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सिम्बियोटिक प्लांट। The body of lichen consists of algae and fungi. They live in close physical contact with each other. Algae provide food to fungi. In return, fungi provide shelter, water, and minerals to algae. As we discussed in the above, symbiotic plant that depends on other plant for their food. Lichen is the good example of symbiotic plant because lichen depends upon other plant. Lichen's body consists of algae and fungi. They are mutually related to each other, that they both are benefited. Algae provide food to fungi, and in return fungi provide shelter, water, and minerals to algae. Question number 7, what do you understand by parasitic plant? These plants get their food from another green plant known as host. They do not have chlorophyll in their body. Example, deuter and mistletoe. Parasitic plant did not have chlorophyll in their body, so they did not prepare their food by themselves. So they depend upon other green plant known as host. Example of parasitic plants are deuter and mistletoe. Question number 8, how do plants get carbon dioxide and water? Carbon dioxide enters in the leaf through the tiny pores called stomata. They are found on the underside of the leaf. Water is absorbed from the soil by small roots here in the ground. They are special conducting tubes called xylem, which carry water to the food making cell in the leaves. Carbon dioxide and water are the two major components on the process of photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide present in the air enters into the leaf through the tiny